Guys, welcome to my new ASMR video. So today, some people requested that I should make a video teaching Finnish. So, teaching you basic Finnish or something like that. So today I will try my best and teach you some basic Finnish. And I'm gonna teach you the Finnish that is actually spoken and not what is written. Because if you actually go to like a Finnish course or something, they're probably gonna teach you language that absolutely nobody uses, so I will actually teach you words and phrases that you can use and not get embarrassed. Just stuff that you can actually use, not like the sophisticated stuff that is written on the books and stuff like that. So nobody speaks like that. Nobody speaks like the way they write in the books. I am not a teacher, and I don't think I've ever taught Finnish to anyone, like actually, but today I'll try. I have a trusty notebook here that looks like this. I got this from New York. We were visiting some random place. And I will try to write something down in here and maybe teach you. I think the first thing that should definitely be taught is the alphabet. So the alphabet I actually haven't written down here. Look, this is just scribbles. What have I done here? So let's see the alphabet. Let me search for a page that isn't completely destroyed. Now how am I gonna do this while on camera? So the Finnish alphabet is very similar to the English one. Or it's actually completely the same, but we have three characters more. So the first one we have is, of course, is your favorite, which is ah. And it's ah, it's not a, it's ah. Okay, I'm just gonna write them all down and then say them, okay? Okay, I have wrote the alphabet for you. Here it is. Let's just get, let's see what we have. So the first one is ah, and it goes like this. I'm just gonna read it the Finnish way. So it would be a, b, c, d, e, f, g. It is a G. It looked weird. A, b, c, d, e, f, g, o, e. Sorry. Similar to a lot of European alphabets. Like the pronunciation is very literal, so you just read it how it is. A, B, C, D. It's not A, B. It's not B, it's B. Like in a lot of different languages. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, O, E, Y, 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 Go, L, M, N, O, B, Q, R. R as an R. We roll our R's, so it's R. It's not R. It's R. S T U V. I said double V, but this is just basically a normal V, but it's a V, maybe like a V, like you know, V. Yeah. X U Z. We say Z. O A. So these last three ones here, those are the ones that you're not gonna like find in the English alphabet. So this is, we call it the Ruotsalainen O, which is like the Swedish O. It's just pronounced O, the same as you would say this one, the normal O. It's just O, 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 O. This is A, 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 A. The A with the two dots, and this U, so O, A, U. Those are like the weird ones that you're not gonna find English one. So that's the alphabet. I can read it to you still like this way, like A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, B, Q, R, S, T, U, V, X, U to the O, L, B, W, X, U to the O, L. It's not a hard alphabet. It's very easy. The way it's written is the way you read it. No weird stuff. And there's no, basically no exceptions. But I think we could just start with some basic phrases, because, you know, I think you just want to learn a little So the most, probably the most common way to say hello is, can you focus? It's moi. Hello is moi, 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 moi. M-O-E, moi. Moi. So that's probably the most common way to say hello. There's also other ways. So you could also say these ones here. So that would be moi. This we have moikka, terve, and hey. So this is pretty Swedish. If you know the hey with the J at the end, but we have an E, so hey. Terve is probably a little bit, if you're from the countryside, we don't really use it here, but you can say terve. Moikka, 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 moikka. That's what a lot of people use, maybe like on YouTube or something when they start a video. They say moikka. But this one also works as goodbye, moikka, moikka. But you can also say hello. But moi is probably the most commonly used, and probably the one you should know is moi. Moi. Ah, moi. Moi, 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 moi. Moi. So keep that in mind. And the next one should probably be like, how are you? Or something like that. So let me write, how are you? I'm kind of running out of space here, but here is, how are you? Down here. So, how are you? Mitä kuuluu? Just basically what. You could say mitä, mitä, like what, what. But here you ask mitä, so how. Kuuluu is basically doing, but yeah, but you can't say what the dog doing with the kuuluu. Kuuluu is just used for how are you. Mitä kuuluu, so how you doing, basically. Our literal translation of mitä kuuluu, maybe something to hear about hearing. Mitä kuuluu? I don't know. Well, it's how are you? You can say moi, moi, mitä kuuluu? Moi, mitä kuuluu? Tai hei, mitä kuuluu? Tai or terve, mitä kuuluu? You can also say miten menee, miten menee. Mitä sulle kuuluu? Mitä kuuluu? That's the only thing you really need to know. Mitä kuuluu? Moi, mitä kuuluu? And when someone asks you, how are you, you can answer with, I can't see my camera, bro. You can you see it on the left there? It says, there. Sorry about my awful handwriting, but there it says, ihan hyvä. You can answer with ihan hyvä. They ask you, how are you? Mitä kuuluu? Mitä kuuluu? You can ask, when they ask you, moi, mitä kuuluu? You can ask, ihan hyvä, ihan hyvä, which just means pretty good. Ihan, pretty, pretty, hyvä, good. So ihan hyvä, pretty good. Yeah. When you have asked, moi, mitä kuuluu? Ihan hyvä. You can say, my name is. I don't know why you would say that, but if you want to say, my name is, it's as simple as this phrase here, which I can't see again because I just can't see it. What the heck? How can I see it? I wrote it somewhere over there. Can you see it? Yeah, it's supposed to be over there, and it says mun nimi on, mun nimi on, mun nimi on, mun nimi on. But I can't see it. Why did you go like this? Oh, there, that works a little bit better. There, mun. Nimi on, mun nimi on, and then blank. So, my name is, then your name. Mun nimi on Blue. It's not actually Blue. Mun nimi on Emil, Emil, Emil. So, mun nimi on Emil. Mun nimi on Emil. This is more of a slang way to say it, because if you were to say it, like, actually, it would be minun nimeni on Emil, not mun nimi, but minun nimeni. But that's hard. Nobody says minun nimeni on. They say mun nimi on. Okay. Moi. Mitä kuuluu? Ihan hyvää. Mun nimi on. What is your name? And then if you then want to say where you're from, because you're probably not Finnish, you can say olen, and then the country you're from. Or if you want to say I'm like a, well, if I were to say I'm Finnish, I would say olen suomalainen. But here I wrote a few different things, so you can say olen, and then where you're from. If you're Finnish, olen, then olen. So I put olen saksalainen, olen ranskalainen, olen ruotsalainen, olen indonesialainen, olen espanjalainen, olen amerikkalainen. So how it just works, that you need to know the country you're from. What is the country where you're from in Finnish? So Saksa, here, the first Saksa, saksalainen. Saksa is the country, Saksa, and because you're from Germany, you add the Leinen at the end, so Saksa, Leinen. Saksa is Germany, Leinen, you're from Germany, Saksalainen. Same with here, Ranska is France, so Ranska, Leinen. So, France, Leinen, France, Ranska, Leinen, you're from France, Ranskalainen. And then you have Ruotsalainen. So Ruotsalainen is Swedish, so you are from here. It's actually a little bit different, because Sweden is Ruotsi, but then it translates to Ruotsalainen, not Ruotsilainen. It's not Ruotsalainen, it's Ruotsalainen, okay. And then we have Indonesialainen. If you're from Indonesia, again, just Indonesia is Indonesia and Finnish, Indonesia, and at the end, Lainen, Indonesialainen. Same with Spanish, we have Spain, which is España, and España, Leinen, again, just the country and the Leinen at the end. And the last one is, of course, American, so America is America, America, Leinen, okay, that is very easy, right, America, Leinen. So it's basically for every single country, it's like that. If you're from Norway, you can say olen norjalainen. If you're from Italy, olen italialainen. If you're from the UK, olen englantilainen. Sveitsiläinen, olen portugalilainen. Olen korealainen, olen japanilainen, olen kiinalainen, olen australianainen. Australialainen, not nainen. Yeah, actually very important. If you for some reason miss say it and say olen Saksa, if that L, Saksalainen, if that L turns into an N, then you are, it turns into a woman. So if you don't say Saksalainen, but you say Saksanainen by mistake, I don't know why, if you say Saksanainen, then it means you are a German woman. Same with every single language, so then it would be a Ranskanainen, French woman, France woman, actually. So don't say it wrong. I think I said Australialainen. It's Australialainen, not Australianainen. But small things matter. Okay, so that's how you say olen, and then where you're from. It's a little bit hard, because you do need to know the country, what the country is in Finnish. Most countries are the same, but of course Saksa is not the same, Ranska is not the same, Ruotsi is not the same, Indonesia is the same, España is the same, and America is basically the same. England is the same, Irlanti is pretty close, Tanska is Denmark, Viro is Estonia, Liettua, Latvia, Venäjä is Russia. So there are differences, but quite a lot of them are the same. It's like Slovenia, Slovakia, these are all the same, but just pronounced with this alphabet, you know. Okay, I'm gonna teach you the numbers. To 10, 1 to 10, because I don't know what else to really teach. Okay, so the numbers from 1 to 10, let me write them down. So the first one would be here. Okay, so I just wrote down all the numbers from 1 to 10. Let's just see what we have here. So the numbers from 1 to 10. Where did I put the first? Is that number 1? Number 1 we have, let me just read them first. So we have yksi, kaksi, kolme, neljä, viisi, kuusi, seitsemän, kahdeksan, yhdeksän, kymmenen. Alright, so those are the numbers from 1 to 10. It's not, again, it's not that hard. Number one, uksi, uksi. Number two, kaksi, kaksi. Number three, kolme, kolme. Number four, neljä, neljä. Number five, viisi, viisi. Number six, kuusi, kuusi. Number seven, seitsemän, seitsemän. Okay, number eight, kahdeksan, kahdeksan. Number nine, yhdeksän, yhdeksän. And number ten, kymmenen, kymmenen. I'll show you them one more time. I don't know if you can even understand what I've written here, but yksi, kaksi, kolme, neljä, viisi, kuusi, seitsemän, kahdeksan, yhdeksän, kymmenen. You get it? The numbers are pretty easy in Finnish, because then after 10 it would be yksitoista, kaksitoista, so it would just be, basically it's, there's no 11 or like 10, you know, stuff, you know. Yeah, so after, it basically just repeats itself after that. Yksi, kaksi, kolme, neljä, viisi, kuusi, seitsemän, kahdeksan, kymmenen. Sitten tulee yksitoista, kaksitoista, kolmetoista, neljätoista, viisitoista, kuusitoista, seitsemäntoista, kahdeksantoista, yhdeksäntoista, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. So if you just know the first 10 letters, or the first 9 letters, you're basically gonna know everything. See, it just repeats itself. It goes like kaksi, then you add toista at the end. Kolme, toista, neljä, toista, viisi, toista, kuusi, toista, seitsemän, toista. So you just add toista at the end, and when it's the next like 20, then it would be kaksi, kymmentä, 30, kolme, kymmentä, 40, neljä, kymmentä, 50, viisi, kymmentä. So then you just add kymmentä at the end. It's very simple, very easy. Very easy. Of course, us Finnish people, well, actually, we don't read yksi, kaksi, kolme, neljä. We say yka, kone, viku, seka, syskin, pikytä, kaksi, kone, like that. So then it would be yka, kone, viku, se, kasi, ysi, kymppi, yto, kato, koto, ne, to, viito, kuto, se, to, kasto, ysto, kaskut, kastu, like that. So we don't say yksi, toista, kaksi, toista, or yksi, kaksi, kolme. Y, K, K, N, V, Q, C, 8, 9, 10, Y, T, K, T, K, T, N, T, V, T. If you want to learn that, you can say Y, K, K, and not 1, 2, 3. Well, apart from 1, which is 1, you just say Y, then you say the first letters of basically everything. K, K, N, V, Q, C, then here you say 8, and then 9. And then kymppi, but it's actually very simple. I haven't even thought of that. That's how you can count very much faster, and everyone's gonna understand. And you're gonna sound cooler if you count yka, kone, viku. That's just a better way to count, in my opinion, as well. Okay, so let's do a little recap of what we've learned. Have we learned anything? Probably not. But that's just my mistake, because I don't know how to teach Finnish. What did I teach? I said moi, moi. Mitä kuuluu? Ihan hyvää. Olen. Where are you from? Olen saksalainen. And then you can count. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Or in a cool way. Y, K, K, N, V, Q, C, 8, 9, 10. Okay. I think that concludes our Finnish lesson today. I hope you enjoyed this and learned at least something new. Tell me what I should be teaching in the next videos if you are interested in the Finnish language. Not a lot of people are, probably, but it's what I speak, so whatever. I can make videos of it. It's pretty fun. Make sure to comment and like, and this was recorded on my new camera. I know that the colors are still a little off. I'm sorry about that. I'll try to fix them as we go on. But thank you guys so much for